I really love the field of nanoelectronics because I like to think about the new physics and the new materials, and I also like to think about how could this become something useful in the future. My area of research is on using new physics and new materials to think of new ways to encode information for the future of computing. We're at a very exciting time in computing where we're at this crossroads. We're seeing pressure from two sides. On the small scale, we've been improving our computers by scaling down the size of our transistors and packing them more densely together. But we're reaching the limit at which we can continue to do that in order to improve the energy efficiency and speed of our computers. On the large scale, we are in an era of big data computing where there are these problems we want to address, such as real-time image recognition or DNA sequencing, that are providing us these massive amounts of data that need to be processed in real time. There are two main materials that we are interested in. The one is nanomagnetic materials, and the other is low-dimensional or two-dimensional materials. With nanomagnets, to think of a magnet now scaled down to a very small size, there's a lot more complexity to the behavior that we can use to encode information. So things like quantum mechanics come into play. Specifically, I'm studying how spins behave in these low-dimensional materials. So this relates back to my general focus on nanomagnetism and spin at the nanoscale. So we do very controlled growth of nanometer thick materials using what's called sputter deposition. And then we're doing patterning into these nanoscale devices using electron beam lithography. And then when we're done, we do electrical testing. We also do optical testing. So we shine light on our devices and see how the light interacts with the electrons in the material. And we use these different techniques to learn about the materials and also about the device behavior. So is it behaving how we designed it to be? One of the reasons that I wanted to become a professor is because I do love teaching as well as research. And so it's a great job where I get to spend time doing both. I do try in my work to always include undergraduates in my work. So we had two undergraduates working in my group last year. We had a summer undergraduate student. And this year we have an undergraduate and also even a high school student who is working in our group. I think role models are very important for girls and also kids in general who might be inspired to go into science and engineering, because a lot about deciding what to do in life is about realizing that it is something you can do. And so if you see someone who is a science engineer who can inspire you, you can realize, oh, that's a direction I could go to in my life. And it's not scary, it's something that is actually fun and exciting.